Going to Jones Street?
I get today.
I'm Laureen Baxter. Welcome to Savannah. What can I get you to drink?
Well, Mr. Kelsey.
We have a little business to attend to first. Confidentiality agreement. Just boilerplate stuff.
Town and Country flew me down to write a 500-word story on a Christmas party.
It's not just any party.
I'm not going to sign that.
Promise to be fair?
Yes, of course.
Jim?
Let's take a walk, shall we, sport?
Would you all mind?
Oh, not at all, Betty.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
This is your house?
Mm-hmm. They're still setting up for the party tonight.
I thought the party was tomorrow night.
Tonight is for bachelors. Gentlemen only.
Have you met Mr. Kelso, our newest addition to Savannah? See all night long, hauling in raping cans. In a
dumpster, I smell paradise. Don't have to ask me twice. Great party. It's a great house.
You're not a lawyer, are you? Being an ex-barrister myself.
What do you do now?
Me and Mandy, we're gonna open a piano bar.
Look at that.
The future ex, Mrs. Joe Oden.
Keep dreaming.
Hey there.
Hey.
Better to be on the edge of a party, don't you think?
Well, thank you for inviting me.
Anytime. Welcome to Savannah.
This is for you.
Yes.
Would you like me to show you what we're going to serve?
Of course.
Yes. This is a wonderful crab dish.
Yes?
Yes.
Great. Let's get a shot of the whole spread. Town and Country loves its pretty pictures.
We're going to have fun tonight.
Indeed he is, Lucille. Good fit. I have an eye for framing things.
Mercer House, Mr. Kelso.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Hey, little noon. I think we have quite a party going tonight.
Gorgeous as ever.
Well, always. I try.
Oh,
all these people.
How lovely to see you out of bed.
Harry was just about to show us the latest addition to his arsenal. No, oh my God. Yes, well, one day.
Would you care to see something a little more unusual?
That'd be very nice.
This is the dagger that Prince Yusupov used to murder Rasputin.
Fuck you, goddamn bitch!
Billy, I thought we agreed you'd stay away tonight.
Jim, I got stood up tonight and I'm pissed off. Give me $20.
No, I'm not going to give you money for liquor, or marijuana, cigarettes, whatever else you've invited in tonight.
Fuck you, Jim! And you, you piece of shit! Fuck you.
That's Billy Hanson. He works part-time in the shop. Thank you for
coming.
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
Boy, that Jim Williams went and shot somebody. Can't pay. He kid shot somebody. Mm-hmm.
He stood there and he yelled. He fired at me twice, and I pulled the Luger from my desk. If I had not shot at Billy, I...
Christ, Frank! My client has nothing to say.
Johnny?
Is this entrapment, Frank? What the hell is going on?
Listen to me. They walk imaginary pets here, Garland, on a fucking leash, all right? And they're all heavily armed and drunk. I'll call you later.
Actually, I was considering writing a book.
Self-defense happens all the time.
And why are you worried about the DA?
You threatening me?
Look, there's nothing worth writing. And you got no worries.
I will not permit this.
I don't need anyone's permission. Not really.
You need my permission. My help, my acquiescence, or you don't have a story. Not really.
Yes.
Wanted to ask you.
If you're not the flower man, then just leave me be. Why, thank you. Is this your car? Yeah? How about right home?
I just bought this thing, actually. I kind of like it. It's not a bad car.
There's one thing you don't have to worry about.
What's that?
Ain't nobody gonna try to steal this piece of shit, that's for sure.
Now, Chablis is a pretty name.
Yeah, I got it off a wine bottle.
Billy Hansen.
No, Billy's dead. Case closed. You did date my roommate Corinne for a while. She thought she could change him, but there was no way of changing that evil son of a bitch. But now thank you. It's like my mom always said, two tears in a bucket, motherfuck it.
All right, all right.
Okay.
I'll try and track down that real girl. Corinne, you said?
Corinne.
Well, I got a skedaddle.
Mm-hmm. Come on, get up, Lewis. Get up. Joe!
That sounds like a dead battery.
Yeah.
So where are we headed?
Get off, Lewis.
That's a good horse.
Let the horse say, hey, bitch.
Hey, bitch.
Okay, spotlight, shine a spotlight over there. Right over there. Baby, he has been running the doll all around Savannah trying to get some honey. So keep your hands off of that one, okay? I need to spend some time with you.
How are you?
I'm fine, honey. Still hiding my candy.
Oh.
Why are you here?
I want to interview you.
You still want to interview me?
Yes, very much so. Hey, Sonny, what happened?
Grand jury's indicted murder one. They're trying to put our friend away for life.
What is it? You told Sonny that I heard Billy threaten you the night you shot him.
Yes.
I heard you threaten him, too. What was it between the two of you, Jim?
Billy and I had a bond. That's not something that they're ever going to understand. He needed what I gave him. And I needed what he gave me. I'm innocent, John.
I'm having trouble getting anyone to talk to me out there, Jim.
Jim suggested that I introduce you around. Everything all right, ladies? There was no gunpowder on that boy's hands. That means he couldn't have fired the gun, as Jim claims.
What do you think is going to happen to Jim?
Well, it's difficult to say.
You're saying that Jim Williams killed the best piece of ass in Savannah?
Don't you worry. Everything will be just fine, trust me. Gunshot residue test. That's their silver bullet. Jim killed him in cold blood, mocked up the whole scene.
What do you say?
That's our silver bullet. Shoddy police work.
Jesus! Right, what? That's me!
Ground zero. Cops should never let you in.
Guilty of first-degree murder. Thank you.
Jim Williams murdered no one.
Do you, of your own knowledge, know anything of the relationship that existed between Billy Hansen and the defendant?
Jimmy give Billy money when he needed it.
To have sex with him?
Yes, sir. Jimmy's a rich and powerful man. Billy's a little afraid of him, I guess.
How well did you know Jim Williams?
I stood next to him in the emergency room when Billy OD'd.
So Jim Williams took Billy Hansen to the hospital. He saved his life. If you wanted him dead, why would he do that?
What's the matter, Sonny? Gunpowder?
Damn gunshot residue test.
Your expert witness covered it.
Maybe when they were handling the body.
Boone says he bagged them. Doc Poe says they were bagged when he performed the autopsy.
Billy Hanson may not be talking, but his hands are.
Billy Hanson's hand.
Hey, man, do you feel like going for a walk?
Where are you headed?
I don't know. I was thinking about maybe stopping by the morgue.
How long have you been at the bar?
Long enough. Come on, it'll be fun. All right, who do we know who can cause a commotion?
I've never been inside of my water broke.
Get the doctor's name over. Water broke. She's pregnant.
Okay, here we are. Commune away.
Is this where it hurts?
Doctor, wait.
Is this where it hurts?
I don't know. Something about the bagging of the hands. It's a nice special pillow.
You wouldn't take a bag off to put an ID bracelet on, would you?
Yeah.
Would you have to take the bag off to slide the bracelet on by any chance?
No, they snap on. Of course, it was easier with him because I bagged him after.
You bagged the hands?
Yes, I wrote it up.
Hold on. We'll let Sonny tell you. He'll be here any minute.
While we're waiting, I'd like to run something by you, John, about that night. The evening started out as I've always said. The argument. Shouting.
What are you yelling about? I'm yelling about you talking to me like this, suing Lynn and all this here grandeur and all.
Why don't you just get the hell out?
Don't you?
You can do it tomorrow morning for all I care.
Billy pointing the Luger. But here's the difference. When he went to pull the trigger, nothing happened. I grabbed my own gun.
He never fired.
I thought, God damn it, what have you done? It explains why there's no powder on Billy's hands.
If you tell that story, you're admitting that you lied. You lied to everyone.
I'd rather be convicted of lying than of murder.
Hey, Coach, we got it. We got him by the gonads, Jimbo. Detective Boone lied. Any number of people could have handled that body between the scene of the crime and the hospital. Explains how the powder got rubbed off.
Would you describe to the jury the events that occurred in your house after the party?
We got into an argument about a planned trip to London, and I told him he could not go. He became verbally abusive, and I ordered Billy out of the house. I went into the office to call the police, and he followed me in there with a gun in his hand. He said, I might leave tomorrow, but God damn it, you're leaving tonight. The first shot, I felt breeze by my shoulder, and I fired. It was horrible.
We, the jury, find the defendant not guilty.
Congratulations, Jim.
Thank you, John. Thanks for dropping by.
Hello, Jim. So obviously you've decided to stay in town, Jim.
Yes. Living here pisses off all the right people. The painting somehow seemed appropriate. I hope you will accept it as an expression of my gratitude.
Do you want to tell me what really happened that night?
Sport, truth, like art, is in the eye of the beholder.
I cook my Chablis famous chicken. Let's go have a picnic.